We are the paradoxical ape. Bipedal, naked, large-brained, long the master of fire, tools, and language, but still trying to understand ourselves. Aware that death is inevitable, yet filled with optimism. We grow up slowly. We hand down knowledge. We empathize and deceive. We shape the future from our shared understanding of the past. CARTA brings together experts from diverse disciplines to exchange insights on who we are and how we got here. An exploration made possible by the generosity of humans like you.
Sorry, my English is very bad. I can't try to speak in English. This is the plan of my presentation. Chadian fossil sites located in the Chad Basin and is in two parties. The South Basin includes the present Lake Chad, and North Basin now is desert and subject to significant aerolian deflation. They contain the Aira fossilifer. And sediment deposits in Chad, in Basin Chad, are mainly lacustrine, fluviatile, and aeolian. All the terrestrial mammal remnants conserved in the peri-lacustrine unit. And as you know, the most of all human find in an African continent. But you know, just 2 points in Central Africa, the most of part is in South Africa or in East Africa. This singular situation led some paleontologists to propose a scenario he called East Side Story. This, according to this hypothesis, about 8 million ago, the Rift Valley formation caused significant change and separated Africa into distinct environments. In the west, the dense and humid forest sustained the Great Alps. In the east, a savanna landscape favored Australopithecus emergence. So, the man will be born in East Africa. But Brunet and Mpefti test this scenario in 1984 and initiated expedition in the Jurab Desert, northern Chad. The Mission Paleoanthropologique Franco-Chadienne is a scientific collaboration between Poitiers University in France, N'Djamena University in CNRD in Chad. The MPFT has listed 4 sites fossilifer range between 3 and 7 million years. You see the Aira fossilifer, and to go to Jurab, we take a car. Geomorphologic of Jurab Desert consists of a large flat to wetly undulated surface, except for few rare features.
And Desert Jura is dotted with recent dunes, and fossiliferous strata are out in the middle of this dune. And the field mostly fossil found in situ, such as fossil cranium of anthracoterids in situ. Anthracoterids is a cousin of hippopotamids. And other cast fossils are partially clearly due to significant alien deflation, such cranium with tusks of elephant. We use different methods for excavation and to always to collect fossils. We can research in dispersing rain or in line. Other method is meticulous research. This method always most in case of large specimen identification. And to find small specimen, we proceed to to sweat pair. And we sorting of residue to look for the smaller specimen. The different method, actually, we are more than 18 fossils are inventoried. It is the most important paleontological collection in Central Africa. Among these associations, there are remnants of all hominids. The first is Abel. The name scientific is Australopithecus Bar El Ghazali, the first Australopithecus discovered west of the Valley Africa. Chadian hominids display a mosaic of character. We find derived characters such parabolic symphysis, flanet shanks, asymmetric canine. And we find also a primitive character such premolar with trois roofs. This character we named a new Australopithecus Bar El Ghazali. What information can learn about the discovery of Abel? An Australopithecus west of Rift Valley, contemporaries of Lucy, this discovery indicates a busy evolution of the human line. And second, the history of the distribution of the first hominid is incomplete. So you must review the East Side Story scenario. And the research continues in 2001. We discovered another hominid who called Tumai, dated to 7 million. The Sahelanthropus chadensis have a unique combination of primitive and derived characters that differentiates it from both current great apes, gorilla, and chimpanzee, but also from all other genera of fossil hominids, Homo, Australopithecus, Kenyanthropus, Ardipithecus, and Aurorin. The new Chadian hominid is characterized by an elongated cerebral capsule, strong and continuous orbital torus. He have also small canine with apical wire. This is the character like human. And Tumai's skull is deformed during fossilization. We do study for virtual cranial reconstruction of tumor. A study have made reconstruction in three dimensions and give the normal shape to the skull of tumor. Children discover suggest, primo, what geographic dispersion of old hominid. Second, tumor with 7 million years is probably very close to the early chimpanzees hominin divergence, at least by 7 million years ago than previously indicated by many molecular studies. We use that thing for the set of Chadian from two approaches, biochronology and radiochronology. Biochronology is based on comparison with other African sites with age are already known using mammal evolution degree, notably proboscidian and primitive peak. By biochronology, the evolutive degree of mammal range geological age between 3 and 7 million for Jurassic seeds. These results are confirmed and refined by radiochronology based on the analysis of the radioactive elements. We also do a reconstruction of paleoenvironment of the Jurassic seeds. The Jurassic seeds include aquatic mammals such as crocodiles, fish, and amphibious mammals such as hippopotamus and anthracoterid. These animals attested to the presence of lakes or rivers. We find also gallery forest mammals such as primitive rhinoceros and primitive giraffe. We find also savanna mammals such as equids and primitive gazella. This animal tests the presence of woodland environment or open and arid environment. Different methods indicate that ancient Chadian habitat resembles of a mosaic of landscape ranging from forested high-rise to vast grasslands and forest gallery. All of these results are valid in scientific review and vulgarized by other journals. Thank you.